Hello friends, in this video I will talk about measurement of AC magnitude. The topics to be covered are instantaneous value, peak to peak value, average value, RMS value, then peak or crest factor and form factor of a AC wave. The main AC wave is sine wave, and that's why all these values are related with sine wave itself. The amplitude, it is the height of AC waveform. For example, this is the AC waveform, and here this y-axis indicates the amplitude of the wave. So these are the amplitude, and we can say that it is the magnitude of the waveform. So the first one is instantaneous value. The name itself indicates it is instantaneous, so it is related with instant. So value of alternating quantity at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous value. For example, this value, say if it is voltage V1, if we are measuring at some 2 millisecond, then this one is the instantaneous value. Then another value is measured here, so this one is also instantaneous value of the voltage here. Then third instantaneous value, and if we measure this voltage also, so all these values are the instantaneous values here. So let's say it is V1, V2, V3 and V4, etc. So these are the instantaneous value. The next concept is peak amplitude or peak value of the alternating quantity. So peak is it means that it is the maximum or minimum. Here the highest positive value or lowest negative value is called the peak value. For example, in this case, this 10 volt is peak value from both side. So here the peak value is 10 volt, and if it is the voltage, it is indicated by V suffix P, and it is here 10 volt. So we can say that a peak value is 10 volt in this case. If it is a current axis, definitely further we can say that it is the current, that is IP, but in this case it is only voltage, so VP is 10 volt. Here also this VP, that is peak value, is measured, and it is 8 volt in both case. So peak amplitude is this one. Now the next is peak to peak amplitude. It is the values which are measured between two peaks. So if we measure from this peak, that is from positive peak to negative peak, then this value is called peak to peak. And definitely here this one is peak to peak value. It is 8 volt from positive side and 8 volt from negative side, and it is indicated by VPP like this. So voltage here is peak to peak voltage, which is 8 plus 8, that is 16 volt. So generally this peak value, that is peak to peak value, VPP, is equals to 2 times VP, that is 2 times the peak value. Or if we are measuring current, then peak to peak current IPP will be equals to twice IP, that is twice of peak value of a current. The next one is average value. The AC waveform of is averaging all the instantaneous value of its over a period of half cycle. Here this is the important point, that is over a period of half cycle. If we are having the average of all instantaneous value, then this is called as average value. Now why we consider half cycle? Because if we are taking average of positive half cycle and negative half cycle, the corresponding value will cancel each other. For example, if this value is positive 1 volt, definitely its corresponding value is after this 180 volt, that is this one, so it will be minus 1 volt. Similarly, if this is minus 1.5 volt, if this is 1.5 volt, then this is minus 1.5 volt, and likewise. So they will cancel each other, and average value will be technically zero, and therefore we consider it over the half cycle. And for negative value also, we have to convert it into the corresponding absolute value. So these are also considered as positive. And further, if we take the average over this half cycle, then this is called as average value, and it comes to be 0.637 times the peak value. So average value is having formula. Average value is always equals to 0.637 times peak value, and therefore we are having formula for voltage. Average voltage is V average equals to 0.637 VP, and I average equals to 0.637 IP, where VP is the peak value of voltage and IP is the peak value of current. This one is average value. Now the most important is the RMS value, that is root mean square value of the AC, or it is also called as effective value. And for sinusoidal waveform, it is equivalent to the DC voltage. It is equivalent to DC voltage that would do the same amount of work, that is, it will produce the same amount of work or heat in a resistive circuit. Now let us consider this circuit here. If we are having a DC circuit here, and if it is passing some current, say IDC, and it is hitting that resistance, the same amount of current will pass through this AC circuit and will generate the same amount of heat is IRMS, that is root mean square value of this current, or we can say that the same voltage is applied, that is VRMS here will be equals to VDC in this case, that is the supply voltage of this DC source. So RMS stands for the root mean square, and it is the way of expressing AC quantity of voltage or current in terms of DC. Here the formula for VRMS is equals to 0.707 times VP, and IRMS equals to 0.707 IP. Here VP and IP are the peak value, or we can say that maximum value of voltage and current respectively. The next point is peak factor and form factor. The peak factor, as it is factor or crest factor, also known as crest factor, so it is the ratio of peak value to RMS value. Here peak factor is equals to peak value upon RMS value, and for RMS value we know the formula. RMS value is 0.707 times peak value, and therefore this peak value will cancel and it will be equals to 1.414. So the peak factor is having value 1.414, or we can say that it is equals to under root of 2. Then the next point is form factor, and it is the ratio of, again it is the ratio of RMS value to average value. So RMS value will be in numerator and average value will be in denominator. If we put the respective values in terms of peak factor, peak value, then again we will get the value as 1.11. So the form factor is equals to 1.11. Thank you.